Hi, my dear yogis, yoginis. Let's work. I hope you are doing well. And if you are not a subscriber yet, please subscribe and share with your friends the practices you like better. There are many, many different videos for you on my channel. And you can choose those you like better, a lot of good practices. And if you wish to make a donation, you will find a PayPal link on my YouTube homepage. Thank you for being here, practicing with me. Let's work. So we start just in the sitting position. You know, you can use a pillow if you like. Underneath the sitting bones, if your knees are a bit high like that and you feel you're falling back, you can just lift a little bit your sitting bones and the pelvis tilt forward and the knees go a little bit down. So you choose the best position for you. Sit and relax your shoulders, let them sink in the same line with your hips. Lift your chest, elongate the back of your neck, and from now on we start breathing really consciously. A conscious breath. And if something interrupts you during the practice live, you can always pause the live. Don't worry, enjoy breathing. So you start breathing really consciously through your nose, allowing your belly to move as you're breathing in. The navel moves out as always. The ribs, the lower ribs will move to the sides. And as you breathe out, it goes inward. So you can feel that. And as you know, I told you already, a few times in these videos, that we use always the nose to breathe in and out in yoga. We have a few exceptions. Sometimes we use the mouth. That is very rare. Today, we're going to breathe in two parts, like this, through the nose. And we breathe out slowly through the mouth. And really emptying the lungs. And you breathe in. And breathe out slowly through the mouth. Just a few times. Fill up your lungs. You hold just 1 second as you breathe out, then open your mouth, exhaling longly through your mouth. Long exhalation. 2-3 more times. Breathe in, stop. Breathe in to the end, stop. And slowly exhale through your mouth. One last time. Then you start breathing only through the nose, in and out. And always watching the inhalation, the exhalation, more or less equal. The exhalation a little bit longer than the inhalation, naturally longer. Then we go up with the next inhalation, the chin is going up. You don't have to force the head back. And as you breathe out through the nose, chin towards the chest, keep lifting your sternum and press gently here. A little bit backwards. And breathe in and stretch. Breathe out, press the chin in. Don't put tension on your shoulders here. Just keep it totally relaxed. And we go one more time. Breathe in. Breathe up to the top of your lungs. And breathe out, emptying your lungs, pressing your chin in. Now, next time you go back with the head, up with your chin. Breathe in. And then you go to one side, the ear to the shoulder, and you breathe out. Forward to the other side, ear to the shoulder, and breathe in backwards. And you draw a big circle, a few big circles with the head following the breath rhythm. The next time you're back here with the head, you change direction, go to the other side. Big circle. And one more. And then the head is down, so the chin in, and we go slowly backwards with the spine. The hips move also. And rotate forward, spine forward, chest forward, breathe in, breathe out, backwards. Start swinging gently, following your own breath rhythm. Could be a little bit faster or slower, depending on you, which rhythm feels better for you. Swing back and forth a few times. Just be careful when you do this, not to go too far back, that this starts happening. Your knees lift and you're almost falling back. It can be a gentle, small movement also. Doesn't have to be a big movement. It's going to be bigger, easier, with the practice, moving the spine, the hip joints, the shoulders can move also freely here, the neck, the whole spine. And then we go from here to one side and forward. You know, those we have done before. And so your rib cage is going in a circle and spiral movement. Breathe in, forward, breathe out, back. Shoulders can move. Then you go a few times to one side and a few times to the other side. You can keep your head neutral, chin parallel to the floor, the crown of the head up to the ceiling as you do this. A few more times, left and right. And we go here, one side, doesn't matter which side, left or right. Hands together, and the knee, don't pull the knee towards you. Press it gently down, and here you arch like we did before, here just in a diagonal line. Inhale and exhale backwards. A little bit resistance here, so you feel the stretch on the opposite side of your back. The hips also move. Breathe in, breathe out. Only five. And you can always use a gentle ujjayi breath, as always. You keep listening to your breath, the inhalation, the exhalation. Last one. We do at least 5. Exhale back and inhale. Change to the other side. One hand on the top of the other. Backwards. Forward, arching the spine. 5. Head is also moving gently. Two more. Last one, feel that stretch on the back, opposite side. And inhale next time, come back here. Exhale, turn your palms up, relax your shoulders, take a deep long breath down to the belly, that big wave, that energetic wave that expands your ribcage up to the top of the chest. And breathing out, take the time to empty your lungs, feeling grounded, the sitting bones down to the earth. And open your fingers wide, move your fingers, extend your arms, keep breathing through your nose. And then you go up with the arms, moving the fingers. Breathe in, breathe out, drop your shoulders, lift the muscles below the navel, pelvic floor, lower belly in. Keep lifting your chest, one more breath, moving your fingers. Move your wrists also a little bit, rotating in and out. And from here, breathe in, breathe out, bend your elbows to the side. So we have like a 90 degree angle here, elbow, wrist, shoulder. Palms facing out, and we're going to arch the chest forward, elbows go backwards, breathe in. Deep in the middle of the chest, and as you breathe out, you go like those fitness machines, you know? And you bring the elbows, palms, forearms together, and you round a little bit your back, just behind your shoulders, in between your shoulders, shoulder blades, the thoracic, and we go, breathe in, arch forward, breathe out, arch gently backwards, bring your elbows together, feel that the navel goes in towards the spine. 5, only 4. Only 4 now. 3. 2. One more. Last one. Inhale, open. Exhale. Together. Now, one on the top of the other. We cross like this. Left or right, doesn't matter. Because we're going to change. And maybe you can bring your hands together, maybe you grab your wrist. Important, no tension here. Shoulders away from the neck. Space between the shoulder blades. Now we're going forward with the chest and up with the elbows and chin. Breathe in. And breathe out, rounding your spine, elbows towards the chest or towards the navel, chin in, navel in, exhale and inhale. 5, 4, only 3, Two. Keep space for your neck. One more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inwards. And breathe in. Open. To the side. Breathe out. Together. And you change the other elbow on the top. And we go there. Breathe in. Upwards. Expanding. Breathe out. Inwards. Breathe in. Four. So we do at least five. Each one. Go ahead. Three. Two. One. Last one. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inwards. Navel towards the spine. Chin in. And breathe in. Open. And breathe out. Bring your fingertips to the shoulder. Shoulders down. Elbows down. And elbows forward. Up. Breathe in. Back and down. Breathe out. Circle. Five. Four. Three. Two. One more. Breathe in. Breathe out, move your arms back behind you, interlace your fingers, roll your shoulders back, and gently pull your arms away from you, lifting your chest and your chin. You feel the shoulder blades coming together towards each other. One more deep breath. The middle of the chest, breathe in. Breathe out, release, place your hands behind you like we usually do for tabletop pose, but extend your legs first. Move your feet, your ankles, your toes. Feel the energy in your legs, keep the breath flowing, and drop your head back if you like the feeling. And breathe through your nose continuously. Flex and stretch the feet, the toes, a few times. Very good. Now, we're not going to tabletop yet. We're going to separate our legs in an angle that where we can sit up here on the sitting bones. It doesn't have to be too wide, it does, each one is different, you know. And you can also use a pillow under the sitting bones. So once you take that angle, you walk on your fingertips here, you are like this, walk up on your sitting bones, and feet, the toes, always pointing up. Let me turn like this, lifting the muscles below the navel. Come with your arms from the side upwards. Breathe in. Breathe out. Interlace your fingers here, index finger together, and elongate both sides of your trunk. And drop your shoulders. Keep your neck long. Now, we're using all the muscles here, our thighs. We're using the core muscles. And we go to one side, left or right. You rotate towards that foot. As you breathe out, you go like this with the head between your arms. You're rounding the spine. You're keeping both sides of the hips on the floor. And breathe in, come up again. Center. Breathe out to the other side. Like you want to touch the toes with the tip of your fingers and come up, breathing. center. Breathe out. Find the rhythm for you. Keep the rhythm. Go ahead. Alternating left and right. We want to keep the shoulders parallel to each other. And we feel that nice stretch on the back. And we feel we need all those muscles to come up again. And to go down and keep the control so you don't fall. Continue. 30 seconds more. Keeping the rhythm. Getting warm? I hope so. One more to each side. Breathe in, back to the center. Breathe out. Bring your arms parallel to the floor. Turn your palms up. And like something is pulling you. Left, right, the legs, the arms, stretching, traction. Stay there for another breath. Breathe in and breathe out. Lean forward. Maybe you touch the floor with the hands or touch your legs or even your feet or your toes. Doesn't matter where you are. Everything is perfect if you're breathing. And just let go for a few breaths. Bend forward. Five. Four. Long and deep breathing. Three. Two. Gently elongating the trunk with inhalation. One more and breathing out, just allowing the trunk to sink. Still, we keep the bandhas, we keep the muscles here engaged. Lower belly, pelvic floor, and we breathe in. Come on. Breathe out, slowly grab the back of your knees. Bring your feet parallel to each other. Now we go to the tabletop. Rotate your shoulders back, place your hands. Open your fingers and your toes. Press, breathe in, come all the way up. Maybe dropping the head back and we stay. And press all your fingers and your toes equally. And your yoga mat, distributing your weight. One more deep breath. Chin in and exhale. Lower your hips. Touch the floor. Stay here for a moment. And grab the back of the knees again. And bring your feet, your knees together for the boat. Navasana. And you can also touch the fingertips of the floor, lift your chest, maybe extend your legs, breathe. Five, four, gentle ujjayi, three, two, one. Exhale, flex your feet, lower your legs. Extend your legs and sit on your sitting bones. Hips moving forward, arms from the side, breathe in. Create space, breathe out. Bend over your legs. Let's stay five. Just feel the breath on your back. No need to force anything. And you know you can always bend your knees a little bit if you need to, no problem. Two more breaths, elongating, breathing in, going down as you breathe out. One more breath. Breathe out. And raise your chest, becoming up, and we bring one leg. Let's say we bring our right leg and foot, and we take the foot like a baby, baby foot. So you take like this or like that. Maybe you can take the lower leg like this or the foot like that. Rotate in and out a few times. The other leg is straight on the floor. And then we rotate it like this and we place on the top of the thigh. Don't worry if it stays like this. No problem. Just exploring how it is right now. So with the other hand, we give the information. We don't push really, just give like gentle information to the knee to go down. Yeah. Now we're going to rotate towards this leg. And listen, of course, if this position is a torture for you, you don't have to do it. Just put the foot like this, right? There is always a possibility. And we're going to rotate to the right side. And so we go easy with the opposite hand, left hand to the right knee, still giving that information to stay down. Shoulders rotate, the chest rotate, we go with the right arm back, the head rotate, and it could be that you can reach the foot from behind or the hip joint or your thigh like this. We stay 5, 4, breathe in, elongating the spine, creating space, more room. Breathe up to the top of your chest. Open your eyes, look back over your shoulder. One more breath. Breathe in, breathe out, turn your head forward. And come back. Slowly back. Extend your legs. Feet together. Sit on the sitting bones. Easy. Let's keep it simple. Breathe in. Elongate. Breathe out. Come forward. And just feel it for a moment. If you feel any difference, left and right side of the body. Breathe out towards your legs. And coming up and bring the left foot, left leg. Let's grab it. We feel the hip on this side, the hip joint. So grab the leg or grab the foot, move a little bit the ankle, rotate. Then this curve of the foot we're going to place on the top of the thigh or on the floor. And we're going to say to this knee, just go down as much as you can without any pain. The other leg is straight. And we're going to rotate towards this leg, to the left this time. The hand here, saying to the knee, stay down. We rotate the chest and the shoulder, elongate the spine. And maybe also here we can reach the opposite hip with that hand behind. Let's breathe. 5, 4, shoulders down. 3, breathe in up to the top of your chest. 2, eyes open and you look back over your shoulder.
One more breath. Breathe in up to the crown of your head. Breathe out, rotate the head forward. And slowly release. Extend your legs together. We go one last time. Breathe in. Space. Breathe out. Bend forward. Just feel it for a moment how it is now. Left and right side. Hip joints, the shoulders, how it feels, the spine, the sacral area. Breathing there behind the navel. Breathe out towards your legs. Now engaging the bandhas. Pelvic floor, lower belly in. Elongate arms forward and upwards. Breathe in. Breathe out. Arms back like we did for tabletop. Now we place the hands for Urvottanasana. So we bring legs together, feet together, point your toes, lift the whole body. Breathe. Chin in, breathe out, slowly come back. Then transition the way you like, legs from the side or simply crossing the legs, transition to the knees and the hands. Take enough space here to move the spine and move again. Breathe in, forward, breathe out, back. A few times. Swing a little bit, back and forward. Transferring the weight to the hands, to the knees. And the toes, curl your toes under, breathe in, breathe out to downward facing dog. Stretch and let's stay. 5, 4, three, also here always with enough space so the hips pull up and backwards. We elongate the trunk, we have space between the neck and the shoulders. One more breath. Exhale. Inhale, lift your heels, walk the middle of the yoga mat and walk to the side of the yoga mat. You can stand on the floor and bending the knees, we go to Malasana squat, extend your arms forward. Don't let the knees come in. So open more space, you can always adjust the position of the feet. Turn a little bit the toes outwards, palms together within. Breathe out. Bring your palms towards your chest and place your elbows inside of your legs here, your knees. Push it away from you. Stay here, or maybe you can go down a little bit more with the hips. Stay. Two more breaths. Stay, one more breath. Breathe in, breathe out, slowly. Fingertips to the floor. Let's extend our legs and grab the ankles. Drop the head. 5, 4. Relaxing the head, the neck, the face. 2 more. Move the shoulders away from your neck. 1 more. Inhale, lift the chest and chin and the head. Fingertips to the floor. Let's go to one side, to one leg, to one foot. And bring your chest towards this leg and the forehead towards the shin bone. Now keep your hips stable. And just go with the trunk. Breathe. One more. Exhale. And inhale. Coming back and we go to the other side. Grab both hands. The opposite hand from outside. It's better. And we go chest, forehead towards this leg. Breathe. Nice stretch on the back. And of course, the hamstring. One more breath. Exhale, inhale. Back to the center, fingertips to the floor. We turn the toes slightly out and we bend the knees. Place your hands on your legs. Come up here. Here. So, hands on the legs, and let's say my right arm here, I'm going to lock. I'm not going to bend my right elbow. And I bring my right shoulder forward and exhale. Look over your opposite shoulder. Inhale. Center. Exhale. And the shoulder moves here forward. We press with the hand against that leg. Arm straight here. Look over the shoulder. Exhaling. Inhale. Center. Exhale the other side. Inhale. Center. Exhale. One more. Center. One more to the left, and one more to the right. Last one. Exhale, inhale, center. Exhale, palms to the chest, stay. Stay, breathing, stay, breathing. Grounded like a tree. And the next breath, extend your legs and turn the toes forward. The toes pointing forward. And we here, come with your arms up to the ceiling, breathe in. Lift the chest. And breathe out, bring your arms from the side, backwards, and touch right below the buttock muscle. Shoulders back and arch without forcing. Be careful here. Don't force the neck back. Just bring your hips forward, lift the chest, and let the head go. Maybe you can even walk with your hands downwards. No pain, breathe. Lifting the sternum, lift the heart. One more breath. Breathe in, breathe out. Bending forward, interlace your fingers the way you're not used to. The other way. Interlace, pull your shoulders back. Stay here for another breath, parallel to the floor. Elongating your trunk, breathe in. Breathe out, all the way down, head down, arms up to the ceiling, shoulders away from the neck, relax the head completely. Breathe. Three more. Two. One more breath. As you breathe out, you start bending your knees. Coming back to the yoga mat here. Hands in front of the yoga mat. Feet back to downward facing. Stretch and just feel it for a moment. Feels different now. Good. And go up with your right leg, right foot, breathe in. And you can rotate the hip out if you like the idea. And bend your knee for another breath, but keep your other leg straight, keep your arms straight, keep the action. Hands pushing into the yoga mat. Turn the knee down and come forward with the right foot. Take the foot, take space here within knee and ankle, same line. Breathe out, gently touch the knee down to the floor, come up here. You feel the stretch on the left side in front, the hip flexor, shoulder down, palms facing up, breathe in. Breathe out, stay for another breath. Stay for another breath. From here, bring your right hand to your waist and lean a little bit to the side, so opening more the left side here. Breathe into your chest. And the next exhalation, bring your hands down to the floor. Toes, back foot, extend your back leg. Step back to downward facing, easy transition. Breathe. Heel left and right. Both sides of the body. And let's go back with the left leg up, breathe in. You can rotate the hip out and bend your knee. Keep the leg here straight, the right leg straight, arms straight. Take a deep long breath. And with the next exhalation, turn the knee forward. Step with the left foot forward. Take space, breathe in. Breathe out, drop this knee, firm your front foot, and come up. Allow the hips to sink. Look at that angle so you protect the joints and we work properly with the joints. And from here, shoulders down, and palms facing up, breathe in. Breathe out, let's stay for another breath while we feel the stretch here in front. And with the next exhalation, go with your left hand to the left side of your hip. And we lean a little bit to this side to open here. But don't go forward with the weight. Stay up here for another breath. And with the next exhalation, let's go there. Transition to downward facing dog. Hands on the floor, toes, step back, exhale, stretch. Feel it for a moment. Lots of space. Breathe one more time here. And let's come to plank pose. Only once today. Huh? Breathe in. And breathe out, knees chest and chin lower. Point your toes, drop your hips, bring into cobra. Stay here for a few breaths, bend your elbows towards your ribcage and move a little bit your shoulders and your head to the sides. Keeping your chest open. Here, breathe in. Breathe out on your knees, round your spine. Move. Circle. Circle left and right. Move the spine a few times. And then rest here. Sit back on your heels. Relax. Stay there for a few breaths. Relax your back, lower back area. Pelvic floor and the muscles, belly, internal organs, relax. You're coming up slowly. If you wish to take one inversion with the legs up, you know, against the wall maybe, you lay down on your back. If you wish, headstand or only the preparation, a half headstand or a shoulder stand. I will let you choose. Most simple one is to place the pillow under the lower back, the sacrum, under the sacrum, and come close to the wall or a chair. If you have a chair, you just put the legs like this on the chair or extend your legs up to the seat, to the wall. And rest here for a few breaths. And thank you for being here practicing. I hope you have a good weekend. And we see each other in a week. In a week on Monday. I will write on my Facebook. This week we'll not be able to give the class. Next week in a week on Monday. Follow me on Instagram or a Facebook yoga page, and I always inform you when the next live is going to be. But no, don't worry, I will continue to do every Monday, only this week not. Thank you. Un bacione, state bene, ciao a tutti, alla prossima.